This is the 2013 Mini Paceman. Now in this small car, they actually get 7 airbags. It's a significant car for Mini because on the back of the Countryman being launched, which was their first four-wheel drive, four-door vehicle, comes the Paceman. It was for those people that didn't want four doors and just wanted two doors. Now the Paceman is along the same lines as all the Minis we know. Fun, dynamic, great to drive, not normal, and great on fuel economy. But there are some significant things with this. It does come in the all-wheel drive version, which is nice, but you don't have to have the all-wheel drive version. Secondly, it's one of only two Minis that aren't made in the UK. Most Minis are made in Oxford, England. These are made on the BMW X1 plant in Austria, this and the Countryman. And the other thing is, this is the first Mini that got named out of a committee rather than being named out of heritage. The Paceman is a made-up name, but it does end in man, like the Clubman and like the Countryman and like all other Minis. Now this is one of seven Minis that are on sale. And under the hood, it is small, but has lots of power. Under this small space, you'll find in this particular vehicle a 1.6-litre turbo engine. It'll throw out 181 horsepower. Now, the great thing about this vehicle is it has all the power you need to get up and go. It's like driving a go-kart. Mini don't hide that fact. They say, yes, our engines are small, compact, but they're powerful and fun to drive. Very responsive when you put your foot down, and it also brakes really well. There's not much weight to actually bring to a complete stop. Well powered, and that helps in the dynamic drive. I'm not really sure what class Mini fits into, especially in their four-wheel drive versions. Is it a micro car? Is it a compact CUV? It's very hard to tell where Mini is, but you need to look at trunk space. It's important. Well, there pretty much isn't any trunk space in the back of these. There is a little bit of space for the back seats, but once you get in the back here, it's very limited. They did put these nice sort of rubber band pieces in here that help you see where this secret compartment is. And the secret compartment actually goes all the way back, so you can get stuff in there right to the end of the trunk. And also it's convenient to put in things like ice chests, a small little ice chest or ice bags if you're going on a picnic trip. It also can put valuables in there and keep the car closed so nobody can see them. But a nice little extra to be able to put things underneath this so they don't roll about in the trunk. But if you're looking to haul a bunch of stuff, this is probably not a car for you. More like a daily driver for people who like to drive fun vehicles. One of the things about the all-wheel drive system for Mini is you want to know it performs well. And we're going to take this car out on the track to show you how well it performs. But there's a couple of things on the inside we should point out first. Really nicely styled on the inside of these cars. Mini has a very exclusive button system, which is these little toggles here you can see to do the interior lights. Also, the windows are here in the center. You'll find heated seats and all the accoutrements that you want in the car. But the big thing about Mini that nobody notices, what do you mean? It's right in your face, this giant speedometer in the middle of the dashboard. Well, I always feel that this could be a little less significant in the car, but then again, it wouldn't be a Mini, would it? Over the years, this used to be a very mechanical speedometer, but now it has a navigation screen embedded in it. Now, some people say it's a little small, but I'll tell you, the navigation system is well put together. I've used this traveling all over the United States, including Puerto Rico, and found the navigation system was very efficient. The dials on the inside are unique. There's not another car company that does their dial system on the inside like these. So there's something you get with Mini called not normal. That's their mantra at the moment, and definitely the inside of this car is fun, but it's not normal. BMW has their iDrive in the center of the car, which allows you to use one hand with one giant button and page through all your information options and the entertainment options in a car. Well, in this particular vehicle, they have a similar version for the Mini. It's kind of an iSwitch, where you can actually use your navigation system and you can pan through things in a menu and decide what you need to select without having to hit buttons, go through lots of different pages. All by the one button system, you can get to everything. It's an easy way to keep your eyes on the road and not take them off to look at things that you might want to select inside of the car. Now, we've played with all the electronics. Let's play with the drivetrain. This is actually going to be a bit rough of a drive for the camera guy. Again, we're on a off-road course, and being a bit of an off-road fanatic, I'm going to throw this car around a little bit. See how it slides and drifts in the corners? It holds the road really well with its all-wheel drive system, and it grips. Now the biggest problem is it's a Mini and it has little ground clearance. So as we get through stuff, it actually hits the bottom of the mud and the puddles very easily, just because it can't get the wheels over it. Now, it's not really made for any kind of rough off-roading, but Mini has a great heritage in racing, and some rough racing at that. This was a car built in the late 50s, early 60s, because Britain needed a car which actually had good gas mileage, could fit four people, and was economical to buy and own. And still today, these cars are very similar. They have great gas mileage, they fit four people. Unfortunately, the economical to buy and own segment, well, that kind of disappeared. This Paceman starts at $28,000 and change. The particular model we're driving today, over $38,000. And I have a hard time justifying that sort of price for this size of car. However, I will tell you, I have no problem justifying driving it hard through the mud to see how well it does.